Hi everyone, welcome back to another Lunchtime with Live Animals here at the Natural History Museum. I'm Forrest Urban and we're here for our part one of part two on fears and phobias. And today we're going to talk specifically about fear of spiders because we're getting into our Spider Pavilion season. Spider Pavilion opens next week and we're super excited about it. We released about 400 orb weavers into the pavilion yesterday. So we're feeling pretty creepy, pretty silky, if you will. But let's talk a little bit about fear of spiders. Right, I've certainly encountered fear of spiders for sure in my lifetime, right? And a certain amount of fear is just healthy, right? That's what keeps us safe as people. And it's just when our fears start to control us, when they become unreasonable and kind of turn into a phobia, that it, you know, it's a problem for us. And so if you suffer from a fear of spiders, I just want to, you know, help you through that a little bit today as I help myself. And so part of it is just staying curious. And spiders are certainly something to be curious about because they are fascinating. And so just a couple of things that I've heard over the years is, you know, things like, they're so big, I can't even tell if they're looking at me. Where are their eyes? Right? Well, that's a good point because most spiders can't see very well at all, even though they have a whole bunch of eyes, you know, usually between 6 and 8 eyes, but they can't see very well at all, especially orb weavers can't see hardly at all. So they're practically legally blind. And so when people come through the pavilion, they're always floored and amazed to find out that, you know, these spiders don't even know that we're there more often than not. Unless we bump into their web, they're oblivious to us, right? And so orb weavers use their webs essentially as an extension of their minds, if you will. Everything that they understand about what's going on in their little microenvironment comes through what's happening in their web. And so they are masters of vibration detection. And, you know, their hairs, their bodies are covered in hairs, but those hairs are for detecting vibration, for hearing really, really well. So they may not be able to see very well, but they can hear great. So let's just look at some of these special things that I think are super interesting about some of the spiders that I've brought to show you today. First, we're going to look at some orb weaver decorations. You may not know this, but some orb weavers that are really common to California, called the Argiopes, have web decorations. So not only can they not see very well, right? They make these amazing geometrical and symmetrical webs, but they also add decorations in those webs as well. Now we call them decorations. Do the spiders think that they're decorations per se? Maybe they do, maybe they don't. We don't really know. And we don't really know why they make these decorations. They're called stabilimentum. We used to think that they added stability to the web. That's why we called them stabilimentum. But it turns out they don't add stability at all, that they're just loosely attached. And so you see these broad bands of silk that zigzagged either through the middle, if they're the garden spider species, or they have these X's coming off the hub, the center of the web, if you're the Argentata, the silverback species. So, right, that's an amazing adaptation. That's just so curious as to why do they do that. There's several theories as to why they do that, but we don't know definitively. So super cool, right? Now, some spiders can see really well. Now, tarantulas can't, orb weavers can't, but jumping spiders have excellent vision, and jumping spiders don't need a web and don't produce a web. Now they have the ability to make silk as all spiders do, but they're not stuck in the web. So they run around and actively hunt other insects and other spiders down and eat them. They don't hunt us down to try to eat us, right? That's another thing is that spiders do want anything to do with us, right? We are like a Godzilla compared to a spider. Would we run after a Godzilla to try to bite it on the leg or bite it on the foot or whatever? We certainly would not, right? We would end up, probably getting ourselves killed. So spiders don't try to do that to us either. You really have to go out of your way to get bit by a spider. And so if you were to say, take your hand and, you know, put it in a black widow web and just really try to, you know, hurt her, she might defend herself. She might bite you, but more likely than not, she would curl up into a tight ball or she would drop to the ground and try to get away. The last resort is to bite and to use their venom, which is really expensive for them to make the venom. And they use it for a particular purpose, which is to subdue their prey, right? We're not their prey. They don't eat us. And to digest their prey. And again, that's not us. So you don't need to worry about spider bites. That's just not a reasonable fear. All right, so let's look more at the jumping spiders. Now, jumping spiders are so curious, right? They have these big forward-facing eyes. That means that they can see really, really well. This is a daring jumper. We have lots of daring jumpers in the pavilion. They help us with pest control. People have to get them in their houses. They help you with pest control in your houses. They'll eat roaches for you. They'll eat biting flies for you, whatever. And they're so curious because they have this great eye vision. We can look at their eyes up close, and it looks like they have like telescopes, and they do have a form of telescopes inside of their two forward facing eyes that they actually move back and forth so that they can see things in really great detail. They have more eyes here on the sides of those two eyes. They have more eyes on the sides of their head, on the top of their head. They can see 360 all at once. They can see depth. They can see colors that we can't even perceive. So they have excellent vision. Now they're called jumping spiders because they jump. They do jump. They can jump up to 50 times their body length. And I just have a short video here to show you this amazing feat. Let's look at this. And so I said they don't use silk as a web, but they do put out a thin drag line like Spider-Man does. And so the spider has a drag line that it's emitted. It's using that drag line the whole way. And then when it lands, the drag line will help snap it back so that it doesn't just go boinging all over the place. Another jumping spider that is really amazing is called the peacock jumping spider. It was recently discovered just a few years ago down in Australia. Somebody saw this little teeny tiny spider like, you know, flapping its arms around and seemed to be drumming a beat and carrying a tune. And it turns out it was a male jumping spider dancing, like giving it up on the dance floor to impress a female jumping spider. And that's what they do. And it's very species specific, this whole song and dance routine. And it really is a song and dance because they're dancing, they're drumming, they're also humming to themselves to create this performance. And we're going to watch a little bit of a video of that. So this is a peacock spider next to a peacock, right? That's why they're named after, because male peacocks do the same thing. They perform these amazing courtship displays to woo women, to woo females. Drumming, waving the hands like he's doing the YMCA. Yeah, it goes on. Pretty impressive. Okay, that's enough of that. If you'd like to watch those further, you should check out YouTube. We're eventually going to get to one of our our new cams that we have today, so I can show you some of these jumping spiders up close and personal. But before we cut to that other cam, we're going to look at wolf spiders. Now, wolf spiders also have really good vision, okay, because they have these two big forward-facing eyes, and they see really good at night. Now, jumping spiders don't see that well at night. They are diurnal. That means that they are active during the day. Jumping spiders are nocturnal. They are out hunting at night. You can find them in our yards. They're eating the pests in our yards. And you can go out at night and find them with a flashlight. And so like other mammals that have a reflective shine in their eyes that reflects when light is emitted, if you go out at night into your yard and you flash a light, keep it right here next to your eyes, you'll get this reflection that you can see here on this spider. Right, this is a wolf spider. Get my pointer out, reflecting its eye shine at night. And so if you're out camping and you want to go look for wolf spiders, you can do that. You can look for them in your garage, in your backyard, your front yard, at a park. And so that's really fun thing to do. You can just shine the light and creep right up on them and just put them into a cup. And then you can feed them a cricket if you want to, watch them for a while, and then let them go. Really fun. Now, wolf spiders also have a form of parental care. And so the females, when it's time for them to put out an egg sac, they'll actually make their egg sac and then take a piece of silk and strap the egg sac around their abdomen so they can still hunt and protect their egg sac. So they take it with them everywhere. And when it's time for the spiderlings to emerge from the egg sac, they all emerge and they climb up on top of her and they all cluster on top of her abdomen and hold on for dear life as she still runs around and hunts until it's time for them to have their first molt and to grow. Then they disperse and they all become their own individual wolf spider living their solitary life. But up until then, she's taking care of them the whole way. So I think that's super interesting and really fun when you find one outside that has an egg sac attached. It's amazing. And then we can look at another species of orb weaver. This is an orb weaver from Florida that we have in the pavilion called a spiny-backed orb weaver. Now they have these pokes, these spines that come off of their exoskeleton that protects them from birds and things that would like to eat them. Because if you eat down on one of these, right, it's gonna get jabbed inside your mouth and you're probably gonna spit it out. And then the spider can just crawl off and get away and be fine. But they come in all sorts of colors. And so this one is red with black polka dots and black spikes. Some of them are bright yellow with black polka dots and blue spikes. I mean, they come in all shapes and colors. And I have one here to show you. Let me switch to my special cam. Let's see here, get the cam on. Okay, well, before we look at that, let's look at Daryl here, the jumping spider. Let's see if he wants to show up well for us. Let's see, it might take a second for Daryl to come out. Hey Daryl, are you hungry? You can see his metallic green iridescent chelicera. Those are where his fangs are. You might also be able to see his big forward facing beautiful eyes shining for us there. Get the autofocus to work. See how curious he is? He's just looking at me. He's just going boop. He's just going hi. I think he might be, she might be. I know, I named Daryl, but Daryl is a female. That's okay. Daryl might be feeling snacky. Let's see if we can get Daryl a cricket. She's just hungry. Let's put this down here like this. Watch Daryl turn around. Whoop. What happened? Sometimes that, they get distracted with other things like my finger, like this camera, like all sorts of other things that are going on. More interesting than eating. Oh, she's turning around. She sees the cricket. The cricket's trying to remain as still as possible, because she will pick up on the slightest of movements, motions. You can see the stripes on her legs, and she has some white spots on her abdomen. We have some in the pavilion that look like jack-o'-lanterns, because instead of being white striped, they're orange striped, and really, really cute. Right, well, we can come back to Daryl. Related to Daryl is this one. This is Daryl part two, who has a cricket that I gave her. She's almost finished with it. She's even bigger. So we did another presentation a few minutes ago, and this one did eat this cricket. Beautiful, right? Those chelicer are so metallic. Now let's look at the gastrocantha, the spiny back. The spiny back is here sitting on an egg sac, so that this lime green silk inside of it are about 100 eggs that she laid. And she's just hunkered down right now. I can assure you she is alive. But right, her defense is to hunker down and stay safe that way. She's not going to try to attack, because that's not what they do. Well, I hoped you enjoyed seeing some spiders from our pavilion and our collection up close and personal. And we look forward to talking a little bit more about spiders in the coming weeks. Because like I said, we're in spider pavilion season. So it's the most wonderful time of the year. And we're going to share more, especially of our big orb weavers, in upcoming episodes. Be sure to stay tuned next week as Leslie Gordon will show you part two of Fears of Vertebrates. And you have to stay tuned for that as well. All right, everyone. Thank you so much. Be sure to see our Instagram account, NHM LA_live animals. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Bye-bye.